Hello, my name is Guy Merin, and I'm the engineering director in the Microsoft Surface Duo developer experience team. Our team role is to work with you, the app developer, and provide you SDKs, tools, and guidance on how to build great dual screen apps. Today, I would like to show you the Surface Duo. I will demo a few cool app scenarios and get you started on adding dual screen support to your app. Let's start. This is the Microsoft Surface Duo.
Ready?
What do you think about that? Isn't that cool? Before we drill down even more into the software, let's cover some of the unique hardware features that the Surface Duo has. This device is the thinnest screen on the planet. It's 4.8 millimeters when it's open and less than a centimeter when it's closed. The device has 8.1 inch when fully open, with two panes of 5.6 inch each. But it all boils down to the dynamic hinge. The hinge allows a 0 to 360 angle, which gives you the flexibility to do more with various device postures. On the software side, Microsoft Surface Duo allows you to run two apps side by side, giving you more room to focus and less context switching between apps. You can easily drag and drop content between two apps and across the two screens. Many apps are already enhanced, meaning they are optimized to utilize both screens. These apps have more screen real estate and more opportunities to interact with users. App groups allows you to launch two apps at the same time, one on the left pane and one on the right pane. The hinge allows flexibility for many postures. You can hold the device in the open mode, just like a book, which is helpful for your morning reading of emails or catching up on your to-dos. The device also supports pen and note-taking to help you be productive. When you're making a phone call, you can flip the device to one side only. And when you're watching a video or playing a game, the tent mode can come in handy. When a device is closed, you can pick it up and have a quick glance to see notifications or just the time of the day. We call this the pick mode. Let's see some more cool demos. In this example, we have two apps running side by side, Teams for your video conference, along with PowerPoint showing the deck that is currently being presented in the meeting you're attending. When two apps are running side by side, drag and drop can come in super handy. In this example, you can easily drag content from an email and into your daily to-do list. Think about what you can do in your app with drag and drop support. Your app can provide lots of dual screen value even when it's running on a single screen. In this example, clicking an attachment in an email launches Word on the other screen, keeping the user in their flow with less context switches between the apps. Consider what kind of activities and intent your app can launch on the other screen. App groups are combos of two apps that will launch in a single click on both the screens. In this example, I can easily plan my day, having my emails on the left screen and my calendar on the right screen. Both apps are launched at the same time. When I want to read a specific email, I can go into a reading mode, spanning Outlook across both devices and get more real estate to read the mail. Let's talk about the tools and support we have ready for you, the developer. Our goal from day one is to meet developers where they are at. We do so by supporting all major mobile platforms, from native support using Kotlin, Java, to cross-platform solutions such as Xamarin, Flutter, and Unity for game developers. For web developers, we have SDKs for developing dual-screen web pages, web apps, and PWAs, along with React Native and Cordova support. We're in the process of adding support to Power Apps with no-code and low-code solution. Whatever programming language you are comfortable with, we got you covered. Our tools also work on your favorite IDE, Android Studio, Visual Studio, or Visual Studio Code. Developer content is ready for you now, and you can access it in our dual screen documentation that is showing here. Start by downloading the emulator today. Then try out one of our built-in samples that we have integrated in the emulator. Our samples cover SDK usage, dual screen controls, layout, and some best practices. We are evolving them in our monthly releases, so make sure you follow our blog post for news. You might have already noticed the emulator that is shown here includes a new button for flip and folding the device and control the hinge. This is a contribution we recently pushed upstream and is now available natively in the Surface Duo emulator. Time to talk about your app now. Follow our three-step guide to adapt it to dual screen. Start by testing your app on dual screens. You can use the emulator for that. Second, make small increments so your app will work better when running side by side with another app. Then, and this is where the magic happens, think about what you can do in your app now that you have two screens to present content to your users. Let's dig down into these three steps. Step one, when testing your app, make sure you don't have aspect ratio assumptions, which can affect the placements of UI. Also, avoid locking to a specific orientation. The device is meant to be versatile in many postures, so make sure to try all those scenarios when you're testing your app. Step two, when making changes to your app, consider adding drag and drop support. Your app can be a source for content or as a target destination. Take a look today at one of our samples. They contain code for you to copy-paste into your app. You can also think about interactions that your app can do on the other pane with a one-line code change. Adding a flag to the start activity for your app will launch content on the other pane. You could also launch other apps or intents to complete your user flows. Step 3. Embrace the fact that you now have two screens available for your app. For that, we have a dual screen design pattern ready for you to use in your app. Think about the different layouts and different device postures you want to support. Which one fits your app well? How will your app present content in dual landscape, dual portrait, when the device is flipped, or when it's in a tent mode? Let's look at some of these design patterns. Extended canvas is one big layout spun across both screens. Use this pattern to get more screen real estate and present more content to your users. This can be great for showing images, map, zooming in and out of large canvases, and great for drawing or viewing spreadsheets. List detail can be great for fast email browsing, showing search results, or other specific details on the other screen. Two-page can come in handy for a reading mode, such as a book, a magazine reading app, or just for presenting long pageable content. Dual view provides ways to see the same content in two screens side by side. It can come in handy for comparison of content or for showing a before and an after view. The companion pane is a view that can help control content on the other screen. For example, a gaming app can place the gaming controls on the bottom while the game is on the top. A video creation app can use the other pane for editing controls and additional settings. We've put together a few design guidance to help you make the right choices. First, spanning should provide additional user value. But remember, the user is always in control, so your app should work great both on a single screen usage or when it's spanned. Make sure the transition between single screen and span mode are predictable and make sense to the user and your app. Let's talk about the SDK now. First thing is to reason over the SIM. The SIM is there and we draw underneath it for total app flexibility. To help your app be hinge and screen aware, We worked with Google to add native support for dual screens and foldable devices. This is now included in Jetpack Windows Manager package and ready for you to add to your build Gradle file today. You can use these APIs to know the device orientation, posture, spanning mode, and if the device is a hinge type or a foldable screen type device. We want you to focus on creating what's important, content in your amazing app. So we've added more libraries and dual screen controls to help you. The Screen Manager is the core library that has classes for screen info. You can add a listener to get notified when the screen mode changes, so you can change the layout in your app accordingly. The Surface Duo layout has a single screen mode or dual screen mode. It has two containers when in span mode and one container in a single screen mode. We also have controls for bottom navigation, tab layout, recycle view, and more content is coming. The hinge angle is the angle that is calculated between the two panes. For example, this is 180 angle. Surface Duo, the hinge is fully flexible and can support angles from 0 to 360. We expose the raw data as one of the device sensors, and you can register to get a callback when it's changing. Follow our samples and think about how you can utilize it in your app. What you saw is our native SDK support, but we want to meet developers where they're at. Let's see some of the cross-platform SDKs we have ready for you. If you're a React Native developer, we have an SDK for you. We recently partnered with Google to add foldable for dual screen support for Flutter on mobile. Check it out and take a look at our announcements. We're also adding more samples for Flutter in the next few weeks. If you're a C# developer, we have Xamarin and Xamarin Form supports for your dual screen apps. For game development, we got you covered with a Unity Engine SDK. And if you're a web developer, we've added new web standards for dual screen layouts, including CSS primitives and JavaScript Windows Segment APIs. But our support doesn't stop there. In addition to our SDKs for developers, we created Figma Design Kit focused on our dual screen design patterns. The Design Kit can help designers in your team create great looking apps. Let's take a look at the Design Kit with a few demos. Another way to get started with dual screen development is to complete one of our learning courses. This is the Surface Duo Design Kit. Start by duplicating it for your local environment. We're currently at 0.3 version. This is the landing page. Here you can see some of the guidance we showed you before. Some do's and don'ts, all the controls, the asset panel, and the components. Let's see some of the design patterns. Here you can see all the design patterns we showed. For example, extended canvas, the least detail, the two-page, and others. In the component part, we have code ready for you as well here. So for example, if you want to use a tooltip, you can pick any of these components and you can see when you go to inspect the code behind it. Make sure you select the Android version of it, and then you can see the code here, which is ready for you to copy paste. We also have assets for you for postures, controls and layouts, and device frames. We're currently at version 0.3, so make sure you check up every month because we are updating it monthly. Let us know what you think and how else we can support you. We put together a 9-unit model on Microsoft Learn that focuses on building dual screen apps using Xamarin Forms. We also partner with Google to create a foldable dual screen code lab that is focused on Kotlin and the usage of Windows Manager library that we just saw here today. Try it out and let us know what you think. Another great source of learning is our weekly dev blogs. Since the announcement of Surface Duo, we've been posting weekly blogs with tips and tricks, code samples, and SDK announcements. This is where we answer common questions we get from developers. Check out our blog, ask questions in our forum, and let us know how else we can support you. Back to demos now. I would like to introduce Andy Hamburger that leads the Outlook Mobile Engineering team. Andy will cover their developer journey with the Surface Duo and share some of their engineering best practices.
Thanks, Guy. Hi, I'm Andy Hamburger from the Outlook Mobile team, and I'd like to share a bit of our journey to supporting the Surface Duo. You may be familiar with Outlook on the phone. Outlook also supports Android tablets with list detail views that are great for productivity. Our tablet list detail view translates naturally to dual screens. It's super easy to open Compose on the second screen, or another app that you can drag and drop between. We even added support for viewing your mail and calendar at the same time. When planning our support for dual screen, we had to be a bit pragmatic in our approach. In the Outlook app, we have over 100 activities. Not every activity even has enough content to make use of both screens. We obviously focused first on where the most time is spent in the app: mail, calendar, and search. And second, made sure in other activities, nothing would be showing up behind the hinge. Let's go into more specifics. First, the list detail view in the mail module. On tablets, we have a draggable resize bar. For Duo, we updated our code to use the display mask API to detect if there's a hinge. If there is, we put a spacer there instead of the resize bar. Note, the Duo SDK provides a view called Surface Duo Layout that can do this detection for you. In our case, we updated our app's custom list detail view. Next, we wanted to cover all our other activities. We make use of Android's dialogue when large theme in many places, like the favorite folders activity in this first example. Duo automatically positions this on the second screen when spanned. The second case shown here is an example in our onboarding experience. We built a container that would put our existing view on a single screen, avoiding the hinge. We also added the ability to show some fixed content on the opposite screen to be a little better than just blank. A lot of our work translated easily to other foldable devices. For example, even without a hinge, we enabled side-by-side compose for other foldables. My advice to you: get familiar with the Duo SDK and Jetpack Window Manager. Prioritize your most used views for the best experience. If you still have more activities left to update, at least make sure you don't have long strings or centered content that will appear behind the hinge. I've included a link here to a blog post that describes more about our list detail view. And thanks, Guy, for inviting us to share our story.
Thank you, Andy. Outlook Mobile looks amazing on Surface Duo, and great that the same code runs on other foldable devices as well. Make sure to catch up with the Outlook dev blog that Andy mentioned here for more details and code. I would like to recap some of the items we discussed here today. Follow our three-step guide to get your app ready for dual screens. Step 1. Test your app. It should just work. Step 2. Make small changes. Consider drag and drop, launching activities on the other screen, or adding pen and inking support. Step 3. Think about how you can utilize one of our dual screen design patterns and bring in more value to your app. Dev resources such as the SDKs, samples, emulator, and our design kit are ready for you to download today. Make sure to follow our weekly blogs, our Twitter account, and our Twitch channel. This is where you can catch up on our frequent updates. I'm Guy Merin, and it's been a pleasure talking to you today at Build 2021. Let us know if you have any feedback or questions. Thank you. Peace.